Hello student, welcome back to the science class once again. Thank you all for watching my previous videos and an additional thank you for staying home. So we were discussing about the purity of matter. In the last class, I explained you how to categorize anything as pure and impure. Okay, so today we are going to start with the next one. That means we are going to start with the base one again. Matter, pure and impure. I'm going to explain this thing again. In pure, I have written elements and compounds. How is an element a pure one? An element is a pure form of matter because it is a simplest form one. An example of element is hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, helium, etc. There are many elements, right? So, why is this element a pure form of matter? An element is a pure form of matter because an element contains only one kind of particle. Okay, suppose if I am breaking the element, okay, if I break the element, then what am I going to get in that element? I am going to get the atoms. Clear? So after breaking, what would I find? As I have written, it is the simplest form of matter. Which thing is the simplest form of matter? An atom is the simplest form of matter, right? So let me just take an example. If I will take hydrogen and if I would break it, after breaking, what would I get? I will get the particle, that is atom only. And which atom would I get it? I will get a hydrogen atom only. Clear? It cannot be further simplified. Under element I have written, it cannot be further simplified. An element cannot be further simplified. That means you cannot break down a particular element. Clear? Why I have explained you in the previous one, I just said you that if we break an element, then what would I get? Why have I explained that? Just to make you understand about an element, that what it contains. It contains only one kind of atom only. Clear? Then the next one is compound. A compound is also categorized as a pure one only. A compound can be categorized a pure form of matter. Why is this compound a pure form of matter? Because in this compound, first of all, let us see what or which thing can be called a compound or how a compound is formed. When elements combine, then they form compound. Okay? Now you might be wondering, as I have said you, when elements combine, they form compound. Now, an example of compound is water, which you consume. I am just writing the example here. Water. Every one of you know what is the formula of water. It's H2O. Now, in that formula of water, you are getting two elements, hydrogen and oxygen. Clear? A thing which is going in your mind is, this water contains two different elements, hydrogen and oxygen. Then how am I categorizing it? How am I classifying it as a pure form of matter? The reason is that when you break this compound, example water, when you break the molecules of water, when you break this water, what kind of molecules are you going to get? What kind of particles are you going to get? You are going to get the H2O molecules in water only. Clear? Now, in this case, what is happening? Why is it called as a pure form of matter? Because a compound is formed by a chemical process only. Clear? The elements which are combining to form compound, they combine chemically. And their combination happens in a fixed ratio only. Clear? Their combination happens only in a fixed ratio. They combine in a fixed ratio. And they combine chemically. And after it is formed, you cannot separate the elements present in a compound by any physical process. Clear? I hope you have understood about compound. Once a compound is formed, the elements which are present in a compound, okay, they combine chemically, and the property of that compound is totally different from the property of the elements which are needed to make that compound. Example, water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, the element which is making water, water is actually a compound. The element which are combining to form water is hydrogen and oxygen. As I said, they are combining chemically and they have combined in a fixed ratio. Now, if you just see the properties of water and if you just see the property of hydrogen and oxygen, then it will be completely different. Hydrogen and oxygen will have a different property, and water which formed from hydrogen and oxygen, water will have a completely different property. Okay. So that is the reason why this compound is also classified as a pure form of matter. I hope you have understood why this compound is categorized as a pure form of matter. Now let us come back to the impure form. In this impure form, I have written mixtures. Which things are called as the mixtures? In my previous explanation, I said that when two or more substances combine, they form mixture. Then what is the difference between a compound and a mixture then? Basically, in a common language, if I just say, or if you just think that a compound and a mixture sounds not much different, but there lies a very great difference. What is the difference here? Mixtures, two or more substances merely mix with each other in any ratio. Here I have written this line, that is, in any ratio. Whenever a mixture is formed, there the substances which are combining to form a mixture, they can combine in any ratio. Means there is no any fixed ratio for a mixture to form. The substance can combine in any ratio. Example of a mixture is sugar solution, salt solution, which we are going to learn it in the next part. So in that, for example, if you are dissolving sugar to water, that can be classified as a mixture. Now, if you just take 250 ml of water, to that, if you are adding 50 gram of sugar to it, the 50 gram of sugar will definitely dissolve in 250 ml of water. Instead of dissolving 50 gram of sugar, just increase the quantity of sugar. Now increase the quantity to 60 gram. Don't you think that 60 gram is going to dissolve in that 250 ml of water? It is going to dissolve. Now, can you find any fixed ratio in that formation of mixture? Definitely no. So a mixture which is formed, it does not have any fixed proportion. The substance which are combining to form a mixture, they do not combine in any fixed ratio. But in compound, the elements are combining in a fixed ratio. That is the difference between a compound and a mixture. The next difference is mixtures. It can be separated by physical process. A mixture can be separated by a physical process. But a compound can never be separated by a physical process. Clear? Let me explain this with the help of an example. An example of mixture, we can tell, let us take another example. Soil with water. You have mixed that soil with water. No doubt, soil will not mix with water. Okay? It will remain suspended in water. That is an example of mixture. Now, how will you separate that soil from water? You can separate it by the process of filtration. Filtration is a physical process. Let us come to this compound. Now an example of compound is water. Do you think you can separate the hydrogen and oxygen from that water molecule by the process of filtration? Never. Clear? I hope you have understood about the difference between compound and mixture. Compound can never be separated by a physical process. A mixture can be separated by a physical process. Now let us come to their properties. Mixtures, the substances which are combining to form a mixture, they will retain the properties after the formation of mixtures also. That means the properties are not going to change.
The substances which are used to form a mixture, they will retain their properties. That means the mixture which will be formed from the substances which are combined, that mixture will have a similar property to that of the substances which are used to form the mixture. But in compound, I explained that the compound which is formed from the substances or the elements which combine, the compound will have a different property and the elements will have different properties. So this is the difference between a compound and a mixture. A compound always forms in a fixed ratio, that is the elements which are combining to form compound, they always combines in a fixed ratio. But in a mixture, there is no any fixed ratio for the substances to combine. The ratio can be of any numbers. Is it clear, everyone? I hope all of you have understood about the pure and the impure form of matter. In a pure form, the elements and compounds, they are categorized as a pure form of matter. And in impure form, the mixtures will come. In this mixture, we are going to talk about the solutions. That means, in this mixture, we are going to talk about the two different kinds of mixture, homogeneous one and heterogeneous one.